So, for those of you who have already gotten an associate's degree, this video is for you. I know that many of you have gotten your two-year associate's degree and you're wondering, okay, well, how do I get to PA school from this? And so that is what we're going to be talking about in today's video. What's up, you guys? It's Sedona. Welcome back to my channel. So if you don't know already, it is CASPA time. I feel like we should call this a CASPA month because I'm going to be hitting all types of information about CASPA. So if you're interested in that and getting just kind of some tips and tricks for your CASPA application on how to complete that, please go ahead and subscribe, follow me, like this video, go to Get That C University because we have some consultants on there that will help you out as well. So all of those things will be happening throughout the rest of essentially the rest of the summer, but specifically this month of May while CASPA has just opened up on April 29th, okay? So be sure to do that. But to get into this video, I had a question asked by Nolene Kira, and she asked, "Hey Adonna, I have a question. What can I do to prepare me for PA school after getting my associate's degree in this two-year college? I'm confused." So you're not the only one that's confused, Nolene. I mean, there are many people that have this question, and they just not necessarily have the question about what do I need to do after getting a two-year degree, but just what do I need to do to get into PA school? So if you haven't seen that video, I have made a video about that, so you can just type that into my search bar. And that information will pop up. But more specifically, if you've already gotten an associate's degree, then your next step is to get a bachelor's degree. So you have to complete a bachelor's at a four-year college, okay? Because to get into PA school, you have to have completed a bachelor's degree unless you were a direct entry. And if you're already in your associate's degree or you've completed it, then you weren't a direct entry applicant, okay? So with that being said, the next thing is to figure out what you want to get your bachelor's degree in, and it can be in anything. It can be in music, it could be in art, it can be in history, it could be, you know, like I guess pre-law or something like that. It can be journalism. Of course, it can be biology, biomedical sciences, chemistry, any of those like organic or inorganic chemistries and sciences. But with all of that being said, you have to be really particular on what school you're applying to and what their prerequisite requirements are. So essentially, after you've completed your two-year degree, what you should be really thinking about is, hey, what programs am I interested in applying to? What schools am I interested in going to? Look at those various different schools, look at their deadlines, look at their prerequisite requirements, and then you cater your classes and your major to fit those requirements, because you don't want to spend extra time or more unnecessary time than you need to. Okay, so once you've figured out exactly what the prerequisite requirements are, the next thing for you to do is start taking those prerequisite requirements in terms of the courses, and then also looking at finding your shadowing hours, your healthcare experience hours, your volunteering hours, those various different things. Okay, because those intangible things, those things that you can't really necessarily quantify, those are the things that are actually gonna help you get into PA school. So after you've looked at what the prerequisite courses are and you've catered your bachelor's degree to that, you should also be thinking about, okay, how am I gonna get these direct patient care hours in? What am I gonna be doing? And you're gonna give yourself a timeline. Are you gonna try to complete this in the 2 years that you're actually doing your bachelor's degree? Or are you gonna complete it in 3 years? You know, and you're gonna give yourself kind of essentially a gap year before applying to PA school. Those are all things that you really need to be thinking about. But Nolene, if you are really interested in getting into PA school after you've gotten your associate's degree, the next best thing for you to do is absolutely research the schools that you're interested in and then start catering your next step, your next courses to those schools' prerequisite requirements. After you've done all of these things, then it's time for you to apply. You can go, you know, kind of join Get That C University so we can help you out, help you get that C, girl. Or you can just kind of look around and Google and various different sites to see, okay, well, how do I need to get a consultant to help me out? Like, what are the things that I can do myself to ensure that I'm making the right next steps? After you've done that, apply to PA school. Hopefully you get some interviews, then you'll get an acceptance, and then that's it. You're on to getting your C. So that is essentially the steps that you should take. And I think, again, if you take nothing away from all of this that I've said, The next best thing for you to do after you've completed your associate's degree is to look at the various different participating programs in CASPA and figure out exactly what schools you want to apply to, and then what are those prerequisite requirements that you still need to complete and the ones that you've already done. And then once you've done that, you can make the next steps into getting your hours and, you know, your GRE and all of those standardized tests that may need to be taken, and figuring out all of that stuff out, and then you can apply. All right, thank you so much for asking me this question. I hope I answered it for you. If I did not, you can ask me another question and we'll do my best to answer that as well. You can also shoot me some emails, you guys, at adonathepa@gmail.com if you have specific questions that you may want me to answer either in a video form or not. But please leave them in a comment section below, because I answer those comments and questions for you as well. Follow me on Instagram at adonathepa and on Instagram at getthatcuuniversity. If you haven't already done so, like this video and subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will talk to you guys next time.